This might be the real reason why you're feeling sick. I will reveal to you now why we're all having nutritional deficiencies and what are the best ways to remedy these deficiencies. If you don't know me, then I'm a herbalist, I'm an ex-med, I have a master's in nutrition, and this is pretty much my life: nutritional supplements, herbs, and healing the body with nature. So stay tuned for this mind-blowing video.
The content presented here is all fake news.
Overall, there are four main reasons why we as humans are nutritionally deficient, and these are all backed up by science. There are countless studies proving this. The first one, which is also the most remarkable one and a huge misconception, and this one will also explain you a lot of things that you should be doing to really stay healthy. This is that first, our soils are massively depleted. What do I mean with this? We are using intensive organic agriculture, and with this intensive farming processes, what comes with it? That the soils are getting depleted of the nutrients. These nutrients, they have been stored in there for millennia, and now we just intensively threw them out of there, and we are not using any microbial techniques. We are not using any techniques that really leave the soils replenished. We are just taking everything out of the earth and leaving the earth dry. And the main nutrient deficiencies that are caused by this are the magnesium deficiency, are the iodine deficiency, and are the selenium deficiency. So these three are directly related to the soils being depleted. These are not the only ones, but these are the main three ones. I will come back later to them. What is happening with the soils? Our fruits, our produce, our crops, they're all getting relieved of these nutrients. There are many studies. There is a new study in 2024 that showed that this might be one of the biggest health crises happening to us humans right now, that these nutrients are depleted. There have been studies on carrots, on peppers, but also on cows, on meat products, because what happens? We feed these cows these nutrient depleted GMO corn, GMO soy. There's no nutrients in it, and we give it to those. And so in the end, we have a food supply chain that is completely there's no more nutrients in it. So what do I do to really help up with these soils that are depleted? I always supplement the main ingredient, which is magnesium. Careful with the magnesium. You should never supplement magnesium oxide. Oxide is complete trash. It's a scam by the industry. What you should also not take is the carbonate, the magnesium carbonate. Those are the cheap ones. You can produce them for like 20 cents and you can buy them in a drugstore for super cheap, but they are a scam. Do not get them. The real ones, I will tell you now, for magnesium, the best one is magnesium citrate. Magnesium citrate, it goes inside your belly. It's a citric acid of the magnesium salts, and it goes directly inside your gut. It heals your gut. It alkalizes your body, and it gets directly inside your bloodstream. It can get directly absorbed inside your muscles. So magnesium citrate is my number one. I know right now glycinate with Uberman, it's trending and it's cool and it's better for the brain and stuff, blah, blah, blah. Glycinate is good for anxiety, for sweating, but citrate is still the best one. Threonate is another one. It's another marketing thing. It's great for the heart, blah, blah, yada. Citrate is still a good one. And then we have other forms, like there's new forms being developed all the time. Be careful. You don't need them. They're all marketing scams. They want your money. Even the supplement companies want your money. So just be careful at this place. Just want to warn you of that. How do you take the magnesium? You take 2 tablets in the morning and 2 tablets or capsules in the evening. If you have a baby like me, then I give my baby it in form of the capsule. I open the capsule and just put it inside the... My baby is just coming through the door. And I just put it inside his drink. Usually I put a raw cacao with goat's milk, with raw cacao and some magnesium. That's his good night drink. It's perfect. You can also do the same with tart cherry juice, which also has the added benefit of having some melatonin. So that's all about magnesium. Regarding iodine, you can take the kelp, or you can also take the liquid iodine drops, which are the best forms. Lugol solution is also another one. Iodine is such a crazy deficiency. Like, we all have thyroid issues. Have you noticed? Like, everybody and their mother has thyroid issues, has a low metabolism, has a slow metabolism, is gaining weight, even though they don't know what they are doing. I suspect iodine being one of the main reasons. So supplementing iodine is also another... For me, it's a staple, it's a must-have. And the third one is the selenium, because also, again, as I mentioned, our soils are massively depleted. So I supplement the selenium. And for the selenium, again, you can get the iodic drops. You can also get selenium, for example, from the paranuts. So the paranuts or the Brazil nuts, they have great amounts of selenium. I know right now there's this crazy news about paranuts or Brazil nuts being radioactive. Psh, they're lying to you. Don't listen to them. You don't need to care. Brazil nuts are fantastic. I eat a handful of Brazil nuts, but that's just my opinion. Of course, this is all fake news. Believe your own worldview. That's just my opinion. So we had the first point and some remedies. Of course, I always give you the remedies. If you're not following this channel, this is the channel about natural remedies, about herbal remedies, about healing your body with nature. That's my life. That's what I'm doing. I moved to fucking Paradise, Cyprus, and I'm building my pharmacy, my apothecary. I have all these herbs. I have all these supplements. As a supplement recommendation, my favorite right now is, by the way, Nature Heart. Nature Heart has all the ones I mentioned, I also have a lot more. I will talk more about different supplements like OPC, like grapefruit extract, which is one of my favorites. Honestly, I love grapefruit extract. Grapefruit extract is fantastic to use against parasites, but also to increase the metabolism. It makes caffeine a lot more effective. And grapefruit extract is probably the most potent. Do not repeat what I'm doing here. This is not a safe dosage. This is just what I'm doing. I have to say this officially. So, grapefruit extract is also has been found to be great antifungal, antiparasitic, antiviral remedy, but I'm just leaving it there. I will talk about this another time. If you're interested, then please leave a comment there. So, this was the soils are depleted. The second one is our fruits are genetically modified. You know these pictures. You know how an old banana used to look like with all the cores, and you know how a new banana looks like. It's just candy. New bananas, candy, old banana was the real nutrient-dense food. The same about the maize and the corn, like the teosinte, which is the OG corn. That thing, it was full of nutrients. Our corn these days, it's bullshit. You can throw that away, never eat corn. Corn is GMO trash. I would never eat corn. So this goes about all the food groups. And have you noticed this, that our grapes, they do not contain the cores anymore. They don't have the grape seeds anymore. And did you know that the grape seeds are a great source of, again, magnesium, but also of grape seed extract, which protects us of cell diseases and has huge antioxidant and radical eliminating properties, so it heals your body. So the grape seed extract, that's why I'm also supplementing OPC, oligomeric proanthocyanidins. It's a great supplement to heal the body and make the blood flow, makes my blood flow more freely. It also helps my blood pressure stay low. So our foods are genetically modified, so we need to try to eat as natural as possible. And then the third one, which is a really crazy one, is the anti-nutrients in the food. You have heard me talking about the anti-nutrients. You have wondered, is it really that bad, like about the chickpeas and about the oats? And let me tell you this. So was it always that bad? No, it was not always that bad. Because 50 years ago, 100 years ago, we had like 80, 120% more nutrients in the food. So if you then ate some phytic acid from the oats, for example, which binds zinc, then that was fine because you had so much zinc, you had so much magnesium, it was a non-issue. But nowadays we are fighting, we are in a constant struggle of getting enough nutrients in. And by always trying to get in more nutrients, if you then add in some anti-nutrients of the oats, for example, then of course you will deplete your body of the essential nutrients. So what are the main anti-nutrient sources? The main anti-nutrient sources are the oats, because the oats have the phytic acid, which robs your body of zinc, of iron, and of magnesium, and of calcium. Then you have the chickpeas, which pretty much have the lectins, which is a very similar issue. It also robs you of these positively charged ions, of these minerals like magnesium, like iron. And then you have anti-nutrient groups depending on the type of food. So, for example, if you're eating a lot of tofu, tofu disrupts your gut barrier. And if you have a disrupted gut and your gut doesn't work properly, then your body will never be able to synthesize the right amounts of vitamin B12. So vitamin B12 deficiency. Many people think, okay, if you're vegan, then you are vitamin B12 deficient. Bullshit. I mean, yes, it's true. If you're vegan, you're vitamin B12 deficient, but mostly because vegans have a ruined gut. And then the ruined gut causes your intrinsic factor, which is the factor that causes your body to produce the vitamin B12 that you need. It causes it to be disrupted. And so if you don't have a good gut, then you will never have enough vitamin B12. And of course, yes, if you're vegan, then you also don't really have good vitamin B12 sources, like the red meat, which has vitamin B12, or like the fermented foods that have vitamin B12. So you don't have these, so your vitamin B12 will always be an issue as a vegan. But that's kind of the anti-nutrients being caused because your gut is disrupted, and the disrupted gut then in turn causes your body not to have the nutrients. So anti-nutrients is like the third biggest one. And of course, these foods that they are proclaiming as health foods, the oats, the chickpeas, they're pushing it so hard on us. And now people eating them every day. They eat oats every day. They eat tofu every day. They eat chickpeas every day. And by using them every day and then adding in a nutrient depleted diet, as I told you, with the genetically modified food and with the soils that are depleted, that's just a recipe for disaster. So anti-nutrients, please keep in mind, this is very important. And then the last one, and then also this brings me to another, the most important supplement that everybody should take on this fucking planet, is the bad lifestyle. What do I mean with bad lifestyle? Listen to this crazy statistics. People always tell me, oh, you need to put more statistics, put some statistics, we don't believe you, wah, wah, wah. Every study is being made for a reason. Somebody paid for that study. Who would pay money to show that the sun is the most healing supplement? The sun is free. The sun is there every day, 365 times a year. Yes, even in winter, there is sun giving you vitamin D. And yeah, now you know what I'm talking about, because we spend 95% of our time indoors. And if you're indoors, then you cannot produce vitamin D. And these 5%, this tiny amount of our time we spend outside, not working in an office, not sitting inside, not sitting on the couch, eating potatoes, eating anti-nutrients, eating soil-depleted foods, those 5% we spend outside, what are we wearing? We are wearing sunglasses and we're wearing sunscreen. And that completely disallows our body to produce vitamin D, which is the number one most important nutrient that every human on this planet needs. It's a hormone, it's a steroid hormone. It's structurally the same as the cholesterol molecule. It's crazy if you do not have enough vitamin D. There are so many studies showing that there's relations to development of cancer, to development of bone issues, of joint issues, of metabolism issues, of immune issues, of getting asthma, of getting eczema. Everything, vitamin D, you know about how important it is, but that's the reason why we are lacking the vitamin D, because we're using the sunscreen, because we're using the sun blockers on our eyes, and maybe we're wearing even these weird military hats that I am doing. At least I'm wearing a vest so my arms are free so I can synthesize some vitamin D, by the way. Every morning and every night I spend time in the sun, staring at the sun, looking at the sun set and looking at the sun rise, just to program my body right. So vitamin D is the last main vitamin deficiency, but it doesn't stop there. If you're taking vitamin D, and most people don't realize this, and this is a secret that you only get if you watch the whole video, and this is really important, the vitamin D, you always have to take it together with the oil. You know that the EDKA, Edeka, it's a German supermarket chain. That's my way of remembering it always. The EDKA, they always need fat, so they need to be fat soluble. That's why most supplements, they already have the, it's an oil base. So it's an oil. So that already makes it dissolvable. Then the second one, you should only take one drop, by the way. The second one is the K2. The K2 is the vitamin K. We need it for our body. Why do we not have it? Because we're not eating grass-fed anymore. Mostly grass-fed beef has a lot of vitamin K and grass-fed milk. But who even has the money to buy grass-fed steak every day? We don't. So we need to take the vitamin K. And what the vitamin K does, it prevents the vitamin D from causing atherosclerosis in your arteries. Because the vitamin D has a lot of things to do with the metabolism of the calcium, and the calcium deposits in your arteries, and if it deposits there, then this can sadly cause atherosclerosis. So you always need to take the vitamin K if you're taking the vitamin D, especially if you're taking higher doses of the vitamin D. Then you have to take the vitamin K2. And then the last one, and no worries, you already got this, but you need to know when to take it, is the magnesium. Magnesium is important, so vitamin D can get transported into the active form in the liver called calcite triol, and all the vitamin D enzymes are activated via the magnesium as a co-transporter. So you need the magnesium so the vitamin D works. That's why I always recommend to take the vitamin D straight in the morning together with the magnesium. And if you're taking both of them in the morning, then the vitamin D can work. And you're also taking the magnesium in the evening, because if you're taking magnesium in the evening, then you can sleep well. Sleep, sunlight, nature, grounding. These five supplements are what's healing your body. Do not get trolled by the industry. Follow this channel if you're not doing this already. And I thank you very much for the attention you spent with this video. Stay tuned. Leave me a comment if you're curious about more herbal and natural remedies. Wishing you all the best. The Exiled Medic out.